Alright guys, in this video we're looking at the KAM KCD3000 USB. It's a twin unit 19-inch rack mount. At the bottom you've got two CD trays and two USB ports. At the top you've got all your control panels, so two separate units. And as they are at the moment, you know, you'd have them, say, set like that in a small club, pub environment where everything's has got, well, basically everything's easy access like that. If, let's say, you had it like that for a mobile DJ, you'd be having problems because you'd have to have that head height, or you'd have to keep on sort of trying to crouch down to get to the control panel. So ideally for a mobile DJ, you can get the 19-inch rack mount units where the control panel can be at 45 degree angle and you can get your mixer above or below that. Now, if we have a look on the left-hand side, if I talk about the left-hand side, then the right-hand side's almost, well, it is identical. At the moment, you can see just below the number one on the bottom tray, I've got a USB in there. So how do we get from USB to CD? It's relatively simple. We press this guy here, which has got CD USB on. Once we press that, then we'll have something on the screen that will say, well, what do you want to do? CD or USB. If we click through track trim, we can go CD, USB 1 or USB 2. At the moment we're on USB 1, so once I get to USB 1, I'll then click CD, or press, should I say, CD USB again, and then the tracks will load up. Now also what this guy can do is, even though I've only got it in USB 1, I can actually get it to play from side 2 as well. So you don't have to have one guy in here for one side and one in the other for the other side. Now the track I'm going to be playing is by Enzyme Black. I will put a lickable clink in the description for the tune and also for this player. In fact, what I'll do, I'll put a link directly to the KAM website to this player where you can get more info on it. So we'll play the track. Now looking at this and then also the 450 USB, there's not really that much difference. If I zoom in slowly, it won't go blurred. Classic. Okay, cue, play, pause, very straightforward. We can loop here. We've got memory, Q1 and Q2. Folder search as well. We can program this unit as well. So, you know, maybe you can play what, track 1, track 3, track 7. Track trim, search, pitch bend. Now, a lot of people ask me about that because they say, well, I press the plus and it goes faster, but then it goes slower again. Well, pitch bend, what that does, it will increase the speed only when you've got your finger on the plus. As soon as you take your finger off, guess what? It's going to slow back down to its original speed. The opposite happens when you press the minus. BPM tap, what you can do there, it's got nothing to do with water. What you can do, though, is as you press that in time with the beat, it will give you a rough idea of the BPM. Now again, a lot of people think, well, you know, one side says 127, the other side says 127, how come it's not mixing? Well, maybe one side is 127.3, the other side's 127.4. The tune, by the way, is Johannes by Enzyme Black, or Danny J. Lewis, top man. All right, MT, master tempo. What we can do there, if I press that, slow it down, what it'll do, it'll keep the key of the track. If I press that again, sounds a bit dodgy that. Okay, pitch off, we have plus or minus 8, 16 or 100. If you do like getting some decent smooth mixes, try and stick to about plus or minus 8, always best to do that. We've got a search function here as well. Jog wheel, so we can search through the track forwards or backwards. Also scratch function on this. Time, we can have continuous, we can have count down or count up. And for a mobile DJ, quite often it's very good to have count down, so you know how much time you've got left, as opposed to, oh my goodness, you know, you're on 3 minutes, 28 seconds, and you don't realize the track finishes at 3:30 and you're stuffed. You don't wanna go there. All right. There is the player. What I'm going to do now is pause the camera, make sure it doesn't go blurred, and then I'll have a sweep across the front so you can get a relatively good idea of what the item looks like. Okay, very quick point here. We've got also this little button here in the middle called relay. Now, just watch this. All right, you know, we can very quickly play from one to the other. But what we've got with relay, very simple. Let's say, for example, this track is finishing. With relay engaged, as soon as this guy finishes, the next track will start on the other side. So in other words, this one's playing, this one's paused up, this one finishes, this one starts playing. All right, there you go. Like I said, I will put a link in the description. This guy here's the KAM KCD3000 USB player. And as ever, practice and enjoy. I do.